Hi, Mariana. How are you this morning? When you get a chance, go ahead and turn your camera on so we can see your smiling face this morning.
What the f-
Good morning.
It won't work. Hello?
Hi.
The camera won't turn on.
Oh, it won't. You might log back out and then log back in. Sometimes, because that happens with my camera too. All right. Okay. I don't know why that Zoom does that. Sometimes the camera doesn't access, and I have to shut it down all the way and come back in. It's strange.
Mm-hmm. Yesterday it kept, what was it doing yesterday? Like, I couldn't hear, like, my volume kept
going in and out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know.
Do you know if Marshall A picked up her packet yet? I haven't been able to get a
hold. Nope, she has not.
Huh.
Not as of yesterday. He gave us an updated list of those that picked them up, and she wasn't on it.
Okay, well, I'm going to try to go back by there again today. Usually, somebody is always at that house.
Okay.
I've been by there twice, and I ain't got anybody, so. But I'll try again today.
Okay. Okay, here's come Mariana again. There she is. Hi, Mariana.
Hi.
Sometimes computers can be really pesky. I don't know why, but they are. We only, we are still waiting for a few people to come in. We're going to give them about 2 more minutes, Mariana, and then we will get started, okay? Oh, here comes Wayne, just as I said that. Good morning, Wayne.
Let's see your books here, also.
Hi, Wayne. You want to go ahead and turn your camera on so we can see your smiling face? Good morning.
Good morning, Wayne.
We're so glad you're here. We're just going to give our class a couple more minutes and we're going to get started.
Mm-mm, don't need to know about
it. We have Mariana with us right now, Wayne.
No. No, he's not.
Mariana, you have plans for this afternoon after we get done with class?
He doesn't do so.
No.
Gonna do anything fun?
I don't know.
You don't know. Wayne, are you gonna do anything fun after class?
I don't know.
You don't know? Well, make sure you guys get on Lexia and do your at least your 15 to 20 minutes of Lexia before you do anything else. Or go do something and then come back and make sure you do it. You can decide when you want to do it, but get it done before tomorrow's session.
Don't break.
Well, McKinley's learning to sew.
Oh, really?
You made pillowcases last week.
Oh, good.
We're going to start working on the comforter to match it.
Go up.
That's awesome. I never could sew. I took classes. I just could not. It was not meant to be.
But fun fast 2020, Mr. Chomps. We'll do quiet, okay? We're going to the adoption center right now. We're going to get adopted from these weirdos. They're in there right now waiting for babies. And we are going to plop inside this one.
Hey, we're going to give them one more minute, and then we're going to get started. And then as they show up to the platform, I'll let them in.
Okay, for his lift all day.
Yeah, he looks like a nugget, right? He's probably so bored in here like prison, man. All he does is hit plates. Exactly.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and mute you guys for right now. And we'll stay on mute until it's time for us to share our thoughts. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and get started. So I'm going to pull up our first video, and then as our friends show up, oh, here comes Isaiah. And as our friends show up, I will let them in, but we'll go ahead and get our morning going. Let's get Isaiah in here first. Wayne's looking all comfortable. Oh, he's coming. He's still connecting. The audio is trying to connect. Well, while he's connecting, I'm going to go ahead and start get into the mode of MP3. We're going to get our chant going. I just love this chant. And I know Miss Richi does too.
I do.
All right.
We can't hear it, Mr.
Oh. Let's try this again. Let me start it over. Okay, we have another friend coming in. 1 second. Okay, let's take attendance really quickly. I have Emmanuel in. He's here today. DeAsia is here today. We have Isaiah Foster here today. We have Wayne Johnson, Mariana, and we have Maya Nika. And, oh, we have Carson with Maya Nika again today. Okay, so we're just waiting on, we just have two more friends. Reese hasn't shown up, and I haven't seen Michael Woods yet. So maybe they'll show up as we continue on with our session. I am going to put you guys on mute. And please remember that you'll stay on mute until it is time for you to share your ideas and thoughts. That helps us with our video that we upload and share with our families of the kids that cannot attend the session during the live part. And so it helps them to be able to hear everything that was happening with our session. All right, Emmanuel is still trying to log in. So we're going to go ahead and go with our pledge while he is getting completely logged in.
But it's great news for you. We're Fed Associates, and we're offering you free information on how to use your credit card to see how much you could save. Call now. 1-800-399-9425. Don't declare bankruptcy.
If you're not muted, please mute yourself right now. Thank you.
I commit myself to a dream that requires me to goal set and to study enthusiastically. I must eliminate negative attitudes and believe that I can do anything. It will not only open many doors for me, but its expectations will develop me into being a successful member of my family, my school, and my community. As I work toward my dream, I am aware that I must not only think of myself within the dream, but I must be determined to reach back and take along those that are within my reach. I must humble myself with the knowledge that my talents are a gift that need to be developed and nurtured so that their strength will not only assist myself to prosper, but my school and my community as well. Together, we make a true partnership for success.
All right. So one thing that, Ms. Richi, I'm going to let you take the floor. If there's anything you would like to say, go right ahead.
There is nothing yet.
One thing that I really love about our pledge is the idea that we are a partnership. Partnership says a lot to me. A partnership says that I'm not alone. A partnership says that I can do almost anything that I want, that my heart desires, that my mind is thinking about, because I'm going to have lots of people that are going to be here supporting me to make sure that I can get those things done. Partnership says we're working together. Partnership says that we're picking each other up and we're encouraging them and we're motivating them and we're making them feel included. So in our partnership with MP3, we have our families because they're the leads. They are the ones that are telling us what their dreams and wishes and wants are for you. And then we help them to help you get there. We have you because you are going to be doing lots of the work. You're going to do a lot of power lifting with your brains and with your hearts and with your minds. And then we have our school and we have the community at large because there's lots of people in our community that really believes in us. They believe that we can be anything that our hearts desire. They want us to dream and dream big. They want us to be motivating. And those people are people from Ball State. They're people right in our community, like, my brain is like freezing up on me. The Dollisons, they're big on that. The Longs are big on that. Mr. Moore, he's big on that. I mean, there's lots of people in our community that come into our building each and every day and they spend time with us. Or if they don't come into our building, they're sending funds, money to help us to do things like this, like MP3, so that we can have a program that's free to our families. So all they have to do is encourage you to be there, to be a part of, to be highly enthusiastic about it. And it doesn't cost them anything. And then that allows us teachers like myself and Miss Richi and Mr. Brown and Ms. Cabal, all those teachers that are going to be on your platforms throughout your life or through MP3, they allow us to be able to come in and do this with you because they're taking care of all of our funding. So when we think about our partnership, we have to remember who is it involving. It's involving our families. It involves you. It involves the teachers. It involves the people in the community that are saying, you know what, I know there's great, amazing students right there at Longfellow Elementary School, and I want them to be encouraged, educated, motivated, so that they can be amazing people in our community and make some differences. Make our community even better than what it was when they were kids. So we're always going to be giving back. Ms. Richi, you want to add anything?
No, not yet. I mean, you're just saying a mouthful. I don't really know what to add to that.
That's okay, because we're still getting more back into the mood of it. And this is Miss Richie's first day off since we started the MP3 program. So she's kind of getting that woo-saw moment right now.
Yeah, I feel different sitting on my couch.
Yeah. Okay, guys, so tell me, how can you be a good partner for your classmates? Think about that. Your job is to help them to be more, to be better, to motivate them. What can you do to help your classmates be amazing each and every day? Carson, can you unmute and tell me something you can do to help our classmates to be better each and every day?
Who did you ask to unmute?
Carson, I think we lost him. I think they must have. Yep, here comes Wayne. Okay, let's go to Isaiah Foster. Oh, there's Carson again. Carson, we're going to come back to you. Great. Isaiah Foster, can you unmute and tell me something you can do to make your classmates better each and every day? What can you do for them?
Be nice to them?
You're going to be nice to them. I love that because you know what? We talked about that yesterday. Being nice encourages... Is that Wayne? Okay. Being nice can make someone's day turn around, and you might not have known that they might have been upset or sad, but just being nice makes them see the other side of that storm, the other side of that issue, the other side of them being just unhappy. So be nice. How, Carson, now it's your turn, Carson. What can you do to help your classmates have a better day? What can you do in that partnership? Can you push on mute?
She was a parent here. I didn't know who asked for that. Sorry.
Carson, what can you do to help your classmates in the partnership to have a great day?
Oh, no.
You don't know? You don't have any idea? What can you do to help your classmates have a good day? Okay, let's go to somebody else. You keep thinking, Carson. Let's go to Mariana. Mariana, can you unmute? Mariana, can you tell me what can you offer your classmates so that they can have a great day?
I don't know.
You don't know? Oh, we must have, this must be the Thursday's kind of mood today. Well, I think if you are helpful, isn't that going to help them have a good day if you're helpful to them? What if you're just, if you, like Richi said, she was going to give them a smiling face that day. Things that we can do in partnership to help other people have a better day. Says that you can just be a good citizen. A good citizen is someone that's kind, someone that's loving, someone that has peace, like they bring peace into the environment. There could be somebody that might have some strength, physical strength. They might have to help lift up some stuff like books and backpacks and push in chairs, but they could also have strength in their brain where they can help us with maybe our math. Maybe help us with our reading if we need some help with reading. It could be somebody that might have strength in their heart where they're helping them to be better friends or helping them to find a friend, helping them to be included. So it could be anything that you can do really just to help someone have a better day that says, you know what? I belong in this space. I have something to offer them, right?
Positive words of encouragement.
Yep, offering words of encouragement. I love that. All right, so we are going to take a look at a story. And I love this story that we're going to talk about. It's going to talk about how we are different and how our differences are really important and special. But also, I want you to think about two things. Think about how we are different, because that's what makes us unique and special. But also, what makes your friends special to you? What makes your friends special to you? How are we different, and what makes your friends special to you? While we watch this video. One second.
I Am Enough, written by Grace Byers. Pictures by Keturah A. Bobo. Like the sun, I'm here to shine. Like the voice, I'm here to sing. Like the bird, I'm here to fly and soar high over everything. Like the trees, I'm here to grow. Like the mountains, here to stand. Like time, I'm here to be and be everything I can. Like the champ, I'm here to fight. Like the heart, I'm here to love. Like a ladder, here to climb. And like the air, to rise above. Like the wind, I'm here to push. Like a rope, I'm here to pull. Like the rain, I'm here to pour and drip and fall until I'm full. Like the moon, I'm here to dream. Like the student, here to learn. Like the water, here to swell. Like the fire, here to burn. Like the winner, I'm here to win. And if I don't, get up again. I know that I may sometimes cry, but even then, I'm here to try. I'm not meant to be like you. You're not meant to be like me. Sometimes we will get along, and sometimes we will disagree. I know that we don't look the same. Our skin, our eyes, our hair, our frame. But that does not dictate our worth. We both have places here on earth. And in the end, we are right here to live a life of love, not fear. To help each other when it's tough, to say together, enough.
All right. Wow. I love that story. Tell me something about what you were thinking when you were listening to that story. What did your mind take you? Where did it take you? Because our mind is always trying to make sense of what we're hearing and seeing, and so it helps us to bring up memories that connect to that story. What connections were you making when you were listening? Isaiah? What connections were you making? No thoughts?
I have a thought.
What's your thought?
I thought about how many, you know, it brought me back to last school year in MP3. And uh-huh. I was just thinking about all the different personalities and how everybody had something different to bring to the table. And of course, how I'm going to miss the third graders. But it just brought me back to not even just MP3, but just school in general. And how yeah. everybody brings something else, and, you know, and everybody has something to offer. And, you know, sometimes you have to just remind children that they are enough and they do have something to offer. And, you know,
right.
Listening to it.
Yeah. And I was thinking, like, when it was saying sometimes we have to put, we're like the wind and we have to push. Push means not, you know, physically pushing somebody, but you might be mentally pushing them. and encouraging them to not quit on something that might be difficult. Have you ever had to push your friends to keep doing something because even though it was hard for them and they wanted to give up, you were like, don't quit, you're almost there. Has that ever happened for any of you guys? Yep, I see Isaiah shaking his head. Yeah, sometimes you have to encourage them. So when she said we have to push, that means that's saying, keep going, don't quit, you're doing it. You're almost getting that word read, or you almost have that math problem right. And sometimes you have to pull your friends along, like say, come on, I want you to join this group. Be a part of this group, because they might be afraid or shy to participate. I need all your cameras turned on, people. Turn your cameras on. Let's go. I need Deasia to turn hers on. Emmanuel and Mayanika, get those cameras on. We can't participate if we turn off our cameras. Thank you. So let's talk about what makes your friend special to you. Mayanika, turn your mic on and tell me what makes your friend special to you. Think about a friend that you have that's really special and you don't want to ever lose. What makes them special? What do they do? They make you happy. Yeah, we need those kind of people in our spaces. Carson, what makes your friend special to you? They let you play. They include you. All right, turn your mic off, and then let's go to Mariana. What makes your friend special to you?
They're nice to me.
They're nice to you. Deasia, turn your mic on. And Mariana, and you need to mute. Deasia, turn your mic on. Tell me what makes your friend special to you.
That they're being nice to me.
They're being nice. Okay, turn your mic off. And let's go to Isaiah. What makes your friend special to you?
They're funny.
They're funny. I love it. Wayne, turn on your camera. We have to have our cameras on. Oh my God. Emmanuel, tell me what makes your friend special to you.
Say nice.
Saying being nice. I love it. Turn, and then Wayne, what makes your friend special to you? What makes your friend special?
You just broke my car.
You do it wrong, Elisa.
What do they do that makes you want to be around them?
Yourself, Nugget, boy. You're my child now, boy. Wait, they're fighting over. She's kicking out. Kicks again. Help. Oh, dude, Alyssa is on the ground, bro. Dolores beat up us, adopted a child. Kicks again.
Wayne, can you turn your TV down? Thank you. Tell me what makes your friend special.
They help you.
They help you. All right, go ahead and mute. And Miss Richi, can you tell me what makes your friend special?
You know, they always push me to do more and stay positive.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's hard to do, but
that's the, you know. And I think for me, it's that they're honest with me. You know, if I'm wrong, I'm wrong, and they're honest about it. If I'm right, they tell me I'm right. But they never let me. They never leave me. They never just tell me what I want to know. They give me the honest truth so that I can make good decisions. And that's what really good friends do. So you are all enough. That's the key to the story. You're all enough. There's something you offer everybody in your space. Your friends just now told you the things that they love and appreciate about you. And so now our goal is to continue to grow that, but then also to continue to add more of those power characteristics to ourselves. Be a good listener. Be someone that's honest. Be someone that's open. Be someone that's loving. You want to add more qualities to your character so that you can continue to be more for others. But right now, guess what? As we grow, we're enough. right? We don't have to be perfect because we really are enough. All right, let's take a brain break.
New Go Noodle Games app. Play at home. It rocks.
All right, it's time to get up and get moving.
And TV. See the music you want to see.
All right. One of my favorite songs. Because when you are enough, you can roar. Scared to rock that boat and make a mess. So I sit quietly. Get moving, guys. Be politely. I guess that I forgot I had a choice. I let you push me. I see some of you moving. So I don't have to be perfect at it. Just get moving. You held me down, but I got up. Hey. Already brushing up the dust. That's right. You hear my voice. You hear that sound. Like thunder gonna shake the ground. You held me down, but I got up. Get ready, cause I've had enough. I see it all. I see it now. I got the eye of the tiger. Nika, get that camera on.
You know what I really liked about that video?
What's that?
I don't know if anybody noticed, but you know, that lead, the lead dancer in the middle only had one leg.
That's right.
He was eating it crud.
Yeah. And I love it because she was roaring. Even though she has a disability, she has a missing leg, she said, that's not going to stop me. Mm-hmm. And that's the whole thing about us and MP3. We are roaring lions, really roaring lions. Our goal is to roar at everything we do. That means go in it with all power, all strength, and be willing to be extremely competitive and motivated. So I love that song. Let's go to our story. Today I have a story. It's called Skin Like Mine. And this is going to be told by, or it's written by Latasha Perry. This is an entertaining and creative way for us to talk about and celebrate diversity that's among us. This book is going to make you smile while it's going to make you hungry at the same time. I love that. Make you smile and make you hungry at the same time. Are you wondering how that's possible? How is it possible for a book to make me hungry while smiling at the same time? Who would like to hear this story? Raise your hand if you want to hear it. I do too. Okay, let's get started.
Hey there! Welcome back to Clark's Cozy Corner, and I'm your buddy, Miss Clark. Boys and girls, you are just in time. I was just about to draw a picture. And you know what? I brought extra paper just for you. Do you want to join me? What kind do I have? Well, Crayola markers, of course. The 10 pack. You know, this pack comes with gray and pink. Oh, you would prefer to work with crayons? Okay, well, I think I have some in the back. You have a 96 pack? Does it have a little sharpener on the back?
Oh man, you are too cool. You know, I only have a 24 pack, so I guess I'm not as cool as you. But can I still be in your cool club? I can? Okay, great. What's wrong? Am I gonna have a crayon that looks like you? Well, I sure hope so. You can never find one? Okay, so I wasn't gonna say anything and I wanted to surprise you, but since we're talking about it, I have the biggest reveal in crayon history. Are you ready for this? Look, check this out. Crayola has launched Colors of the World Skin Tone Colors. There are now 24 different colors that represent over 40 different skin tones. How exciting is that? Now you, my friend, can color yourself into the world and not feel left out. I am so excited for these crayons to come out. I know I'm gonna color like crazy. And wear your skin tone color out, because now you no longer have to use purple, blue to represent yourself. I'm so excited for you. Okay, friends, speaking of colors and skin tones, I have the perfect read aloud for today. Today's story, boys and girls, is called Skin Like Mine by Latasha M. Perry. Boys and girls, just look at how beautiful they all are with their different shades of color and their different skin tones. Well, boys and girls, I think you are going to really enjoy this story, and I hope that it inspires you to be comfortable in the skin that you live in. Okay, friends, well, if you are ready to celebrate the many shades of colors, come join me for today's story, and make sure you bring a friend, because I definitely want to celebrate skin like yours. Okay, come on. Skin Like Mine, written by Latasha M. Perry, illustrated by Bay Jackson. Okay, boys and girls, let's get ready to celebrate our skin. Skin like mine is quite divine. In fact, I'd say it's one of a kind. I wouldn't trade for any other shade. I love my brown skin. Oh, where do I begin? My sister and I are both shades of brown. Me like peanut butter, and she a hazelnut spread. Both creamy and smooth. If I had to choose, it'd be hard for me, because both are so yummy. You see, boys and girls, they're able to identify with their skin colors. Peanut butter and hazelnut spread. Both shades are beautiful, boys and girls. Both shades. Skin like mine is really neat, sort of like a brownie treat. Dark chocolate brown, so tasty and sweet. I love my skin from my head to my feet. Those look delicious, boys and girls. But again, skin like chocolate brown? Beautiful. Still beautiful. When I look at Grandpa's skin, you know what comes to mind? Caramel, that's it. A touch of golden brown drizzled on top of your ice cream. Ooh-wee, this is making my tummy hungry.
My best bud in the whole world, Sean. We're like cookies and cream. When we're together, our skin color doesn't mean a thing. Because we know it's what's inside that matters the most. Color should never keep two people from being close. I think it's so awesome that they're able to be friends and learn together and play together and just learn from each other. And doesn't this remind you of an Oreo? Look, chocolatey brown on the outside and creamy on the inside, but still together, it tastes amazing. And together, this friendship is amazing too. I know I have several best friends that don't look exactly like me, but I love them so, so, so very much. Imagine a world with one hue of colors. How boring that would be. I don't know about you, but I like variety. Like a bag of lollipops, each bringing a different splash of flavor to my mouth. If everyone was the same, wouldn't that be a shame? Skin like mine is quite divine. In fact, I'd say it's one of a kind. That's right, boys and girls. Skin like yours is unique and so very special. I wouldn't trade for any other shade. I love my skin. Oh, how I love my brown skin. Boys and girls, just look at all these different shades of color. And you know what I absolutely love the most? I love that they're all together, standing next to each other as one. Oh, this was such an awesome book. You definitely should be proud of exactly who you are and what you look like. Your skin is beautiful.
Hey there, I'm back. What did you think of this read-aloud, boys and girls? I don't know about you, but I was happy to see so many different shades of color. Were you able to find skin like yours? I sure hope so. And my, oh my, was I getting hungry reading this book. These illustrations were fantastic. But you know what I absolutely loved about this book, boys and girls? The children in this book, they were celebrating how they looked. They were happy about their different shades of color. Look, skin like mine is really neat, sort of like a brownie tree. How awesome is it to look at something and to be able to say, hey, that's like my skin. That's beautiful, and you're beautiful. Yes, I'm talking to you. Yes, you. You're gorgeous. You don't believe me. Okay, fine. I need you to drop what you're doing right now and go get a mirror and come right back. No, I'm serious. I'm going to do the same. Go grab your mirror and come right back. I'm going to go get mine, okay? I'll be right back. I'm back. I have my mirror. Okay, good. You have yours too. All right, do me a favor. Before we use this mirror, I need you to get all the finger marks off. Use your shirt. I'm going to use mine. Make sure it's really squeaky clean. All right, that ought to do it. Okay, now do me a favor. Hold that mirror up and take a good look at that beauty. Look, I see what you're trying to do. You're trying to focus on the bumps and the freckles. No, that's not what this is about. I want you to look yourself in the eyes, look in that mirror, look in your eyes, and repeat after me. Make sure you say it with pride, okay? Here we go. I am beautiful. Let's hear it.
I am beautiful.
I am somebody. I will not let anyone ever tell me any different. I am special. I am gifted. I am uniquely made. And I'm going places. You made a believer out of me. And you know, boys and girls, I get it. Sometimes we do not always feel the greatest about ourselves, but you know what you might have to do? You might have to use your mirror. You might have to speak those very things to yourself every single day until you start to believe it. I know that you're wonderful and incredible, and your skin is incredible too.
You know what? Let's put the mirror down, okay? Remember what the book said? I want you to take a good look. Just look. Admire that beautiful skin. Remember what the book said? Repeat after me. Look at your skin. And repeat these words. Skin like mine.
Like mine.
Is quite divine.
It's quite divine.
And I'd say.
And I'd say.
It's one of a kind.
It's one of a kind.
And you're one of the kind. We all are different and unique, and that is what makes us special. And I'm looking at you. You look like you're creamy, like peanut butter. And I love peanut butter. It's yummy. You look divine, and you're one of a kind. And you, my friend, your skin reminds me of Cocoa Puffs. You're gorgeous. Don't let anyone tell you any different. And maybe you think, I look as creamy as vanilla ice cream. Well, that's beautiful too. You all are beautiful. And you know what? I have an idea. I think we all should draw pictures today. I would love to see you in skin like yours. I want to see all of those different shades of color. And listen, don't just keep them at home. I definitely want you to take a picture of it and send them to Clark's Cozy Corner so that I could just smile forever. Now, if you don't send them to the email, feel free to just leave a comment in the picture on the page, okay? And guess what? That's not it. I want to send you the new box of crayons. So, in order to get those new boxes of crayons,
I'm going to stop that right there. All right. Emmanuel, go ahead and turn your camera back on. Okay, guys. One thing that I really liked about this story was that she's proud of her skin color, as we should all be proud of our skin color, because it is what makes us uniquely special. So I want you to think about, what food does your skin color remind you of? And I'll go first, because my grandmother used to say this to me all the time. She really was like encouraging of my color, and she was like, you know what, you are as beautiful as brown sugar. And so every time she would see me, she'd go, come give me some brown sugar, because that's what I remind her of, sweet brown sugar. And so when I think about my skin color, I always think about brown sugar, because that's what it matches. So tell me, what does your skin color match? Or what food do you look at that reminds you of your skin? Let's start with Mariana. Mariana, go ahead and unmute. Tell me a food that you think resembles your skin.
I don't know.
You don't know?
Mm-mm.
I think you have a pretty caramel color. Yeah, sweet as caramel. Isaiah Foster, tell me, what food do you think resembles your skin color? Mariana, go ahead and mute.
Dark peanut butter, kind of.
Dark peanut butter? Yep, I can see that, creamy. Maya Nika, tell me, what food resembles your skin color? Maya Nika, unmute. Yes. Maya Nika, what food resembles your skin color?
Caramel.
Caramel. Carson, what food resembles your skin color?
Milk.
Milk. Okay, I like it. Emmanuel, what food resembles your skin color? Unmute, Emmanuel. Turn your camera on. What food resembles your
white milk? White milk.
Brown milk?
Yeah.
Yeah, chocolate milk. I can see that. And 48 is Deasia. Deasia, what food resembles your skin color?
I don't know.
You don't know? I think caramel popcorn. You ever seen caramel popcorn? It's rich and creamy. Yeah. And Miss Richi, what food resembles your skin color?
Maybe oatmeal.
Oatmeal? Yeah, I can see that. So what I love about this story is that the next time when people talk about other people's skin color, think about all the foods that we just mentioned that makes that color special, unique, and excitingly tasty, and give that back to them. Say, hey, you know what? That's not really funny that you said that, because I think their color is as creamy as caramel popcorn, or as smooth as white milk, or as scrumptious as chocolate milk, right? Or as filling as oatmeal. Like, we have, there's the things that make up our skin unique and special shouldn't be made fun of. Our skin should be loved and appreciated. And the more you tell yourself those positive things, the more empowered you'll feel and good you'll feel about yourself.
How about cigarettes?
Miss Richi, you want to add anything?
No, I've always, you know, growing up, I was always a little, wasn't very confident in my skin color.
Yeah.
It took a whole lot of, you know, everybody else telling me my skin color was pretty, and
yeah,
you know, for me to actually grow into it.
Right. And I think we have to start them young, and because like my daughter Macy is darker than me. I've always felt like she was my color, but people say she's darker than me. And so as a baby, I did her the same way my grandmother did for me. And I just talked to her about how I thought her skin was beautiful. It was rich and vibrant, and the deepness of her complexion made her special. And so she walked strong in her coloring and never has thought twice about it. But I get that, because I grew up the same way you did. And so it took my grandmother pouring that into me, calling me sweet brown sugar, that I realized that it was something that I should be proud of. And so we have to start them young. And that's what I like about this story, is it starts us young. It helps us to appreciate and love the skin that we're walking in. And the more we're comfortable with that skin, with our skin, the better we'll be for ourselves in this world. So let's do a Go Noodle break.
The new Go Noodle Games app. Play it home.
Hey, get up and get moving, guys.
Here we are at one of the best roller coasters in the world.
All right, oh my roller goodness. Coasters.
I am so ready. Are you guys ready?
Let's go.
It's gonna be great. All right. Okay, our lap bars are down. We're all buckled in. We're safe and sound. Now comes the first drop. Okay, we're going up the hill. Scary. Everybody, arms up. Neil, put your arms up. Come on, you can do it. Okay. All right, here comes the first drop. Everybody scream. This is the boring part. Everybody pretend you're bored. Whatever. I'm having a good time here. Let's bring a smile. Here we go.
Okay.
Hey.
Wow.
Whoa. You caught a bug in your mouth.
Tasty.
Oh, wow.
Ew. Chocolate flavor.
Everybody, catch a bug.
Catch a bug.
And now scream.
You love this roller coaster.
I am ready.
Hands up.
Side to side. Go crazy.
Hold tight.
Hands up.
on your hat. Oh no, here comes the tunnel. Everybody close your eyes.
Close your eyes.
It's so dark. Oh, my favorite part of the ride, the photo.
All right, let's pose. 3, 2, 1. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna get an 8x10.
I think I'm gonna get a keychain.
Oh no, here comes the drop. Everybody, scream. Repeat after us. Now I love this roller coaster.
Let's do it again, Brian.
Okay.
Hey, Ms. Serf, do you have the Go Noodle app or do you get on YouTube and find those?
I have the Go Noodle app.
Okay.
But you can search them on YouTube as well.
Okay.
Yeah, but the Go Noodle app gives you the opportunity to, it's all in categories, and then you can just.
Yeah, I downloaded the app, and then Mr. Long has said something about YouTube, so I was just wondering how you was.
Yeah, I did it through Go Noodle.
Okay.
All righty. So now, I love that roller coaster one. How many of you like the roller coaster? I did too, Isaiah. That one's like one of my favorite. I like them all, but that one really made me excited. It makes me want to go on a roller coaster again. You should get that camera on, and Mary, you get your camera on. Okay, so now it's time for us to do our new game of the day. Let me plug it in and get us going. 1 second. Wait a minute, something didn't go quite right. Let me get this. One second. I think my plug isn't in. Hold on.
Now, is it just me or is Jeopardy spelled wrong?
It's it's not Jeopardy, it's Jeopardy. It is it's a game. It's I guess you would call it a knockoff. Oh, I gave you the wrong one. Hold on, I gotta get to the other board. All right, so now let me pull this one up. So we're gonna play Jeopardy today. Jeopardy, sorry. And we have some categories. We have the category of antonyms. We have definitions, compound words, homophones, multiple meaning words, and contractions. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go around, I'm gonna call your name, and you're going to, 1 second, We're going to do it around one. And you're going to pick a category and a value. And then I'm going to give you a question. If you get that question correct, you earn that money. Are you ready? Okay, Siren's not here with us today, so I'm going to go to De'Asia. De'Asia, you get to pick a category and a value that you want to try to earn. So you got to say either antonyms, which are opposite words, definitions, what a word means, compound words, two words that are joined together to make a new word, homophones, words that sound alike but have different meanings, multiple meaning words, the same thing, they have a word that can mean more than one thing, and contractions. What category would you like, De'Asia? You have to turn your mute. You have to unmute.
Antonym.
Antonyms for how much?
800.
Ooh, big money. Okay, the word is deep. The swimming pool is too deep for me. What is the antonym of deep? Remember, it's the opposite. Deep. Does it mean, opposite mean high, A, B, shallow, or C, wide?
High.
It doesn't mean high. So we have to, let's see, who's next? Emmanuel, are you still out there? Emmanuel, do you know the opposite of deep? Is it A, high, B, shallow, or C, wide?
You call my name.
Yep. I said, Emmanuel, what's the opposite of deep? Is it A, high, B, shallow, or C, wide? Opposite of deep.
Can you run again, Marcella?
Wide? Nope, it's not wide. So we have to go to Isaiah. Isaiah, what is the opposite of deep? The pool is too deep for me. The opposite would be A, high, B, shallow, or C, wide?
Shallow.
It's shallow. So Isaiah earned $800. All right, so let's go to, oh, Isaiah, you get to pick the next category because you got that one right. Let me go back to the board. What category and how much? Make sure you mute if you're not speaking. Isaiah, you got to unmute, honey.
Compound words and 400.
400, all right. Here's your question. This game is played with bats and gloves on a diamond. This game is played with bats and gloves on a diamond. Is that A, Batman, B, baseball, C, diamond ball?
Baseball.
It's B, baseball, so you earned $400 more.
Isaiah better knew that answer.
I know, right? Okay, Isaiah. Isaiah, pick the next category and value.
Compound words for 200 again.
Okay, 200. This brightly colored pet swims in a bowl. Is it A, goldfish, B, jellyfish, C, lovebird?
Goldfish.
It is a goldfish. Alrighty, Isaiah, now the turn goes to, Shayla's not here, Tashawn's not here. Wayne, are you out there? Did we lose Wayne? We must have lost Wayne. Okay, so we're going to go on. Reese isn't here. Mariana, is she still here? Mariana, you can unmute. Mariana, pick a category. Let me go back to our game board. A category and a value.
Compound words and 200.
Compound words for 200. Oh, wait, 200's gone. We only have 600, 800, and 2,000.
600.
For 600. All right. Here's your question. This is when the ground shakes. This is when the ground shakes. Is that called A, groundbreaking, B, landfill, or C, earthquake?
Earthquake.
It is an earthquake. So you got $600, Mariana. And let's go back to our game board. Mariana, pick another category and value.
Compound words. And 800.
All right. It says you do this when something makes you, when something makes sense to you. You do this when something makes sense to you. A, understand. B, tiptoe. Or C, blackout. You do this when something makes sense to you. A, understand. B, tiptoe. C, blackout.
Understand.
You understand it. That's right. So you earned $800. You're up to $1,400. So now the turn goes to Carson. Are you out there, Carson?
Yeah, I'm out here.
Okay, Carson, pick a category and a value.
Adjectives for 2,000.
Antonyms for 2,000. All righty, here's your question. 2,000. Ooh, he went for a big one. The word is tame. The word is tame. The deer was so tame that I was able to pet it. What is the opposite of tame? A, tammy. B, wild. Or C, wild. The opposite of tame. Nope, it's not tammy. It's not tammy. We have to go to, is Michael still here? Nope. Let's go back to Deasia. Deasia. Deasia, unmute.
I did.
Okay, Deasia. What is the opposite of tame? The deer was so tame that I was able to pet it. The antonym or opposite. Is it A, tammy, B, wild, or C, wild?
Wild.
It's wild. So you earned $2,000, Deasia. Good job. Okay, Deasia, you get to pick a category. Let's go back to our game board. Pick a category and a value.
Homophones.
Homophones. For how much?
800.
800.
Again.
All right. Which homophone means 60 minutes? Which homophone means 60 minutes? Is it A, hour, B, hour, or C, R?
R.
It's not R. So we have to pass it over to Emmanuel. Emmanuel, Deasia, mute.
Okay.
And then Emmanuel, unmute.
Yeah.
Which homophone means 60 minutes? Is it A, hour, B, hour, or C, R? A, B, or C?
A,
B, or C?
A.
Nope, it's not A. You're close. Okay, let's go to Isaiah. Isaiah, which homophone means 60 minutes? A, hour, B, hour, or C, R? You have to unmute, honey.
B?
It's B, hour. And that's H-O-U-R. That means 1 hour or 60 minutes. So, Isaiah, you've earned 800 points. Isaiah, pick a category.
Definition.
For how much?
600.
All right. To be truthful, I need the word that means this. It means to be truthful is a definition for which word? To be truthful. A, honest. B, spontaneous. C, optimistic.
Honest.
It means A, honest. And that was for 600 points. So Isaiah, you're now up to 2,800 points. Okay, Isaiah, I'm going to pass the turn to Mayanika. Are you out there, Mayanika? Nope. Okay, let's go to Mariana. Mariana, are you still out there? Yep. Mariana, turn on your phone. I mean, your mic.
Hey,
pick a category and a value.
Definitions.
Definitions for how much?
600.
We don't have 600. It's gone. We have 200, 400, 800, and 2,000.
200.
For 200. Definition. What does the word ripe mean? A, to tear. B, fully grown and ready to eat. Or C, a thin rope. What does the word ripe mean? A, to tear. B, fully grown and ready to eat. Or C, a thin rope. Ripe.
A thin rope?
Nope, it says ripe. The banana was ripe. A, to tear. B, fully grown and ready to eat. Or C, a thin rope.
Tear.
Not tear. Let's go to Carson. Carson, you can turn on your microphone. Carson, are you ready? Okay, we're going to move on. Let's go back to DeAsia. DeAsia, are you still there?
Yeah.
Okay, DeAsia, what does the word ripe mean? A, to tear. B, fully grown and ready to eat. Or C, a thin rope.
Ready to eat.
It's ready to eat. So, DeAsia, you just earned 200 points. More, you're at 2,200. All right, go back to the game board, and DeAsia, pick the category. And a
compound words.
Compound words, and all we have is for $2,000. Are you ready for it? It's a big one.
Yes.
All righty, for $2,000, this seaside tower shines a light for ships. This seaside tower shines a light for ships. Is that an A, skyscraper? B, a lighthouse, or C, a watchtower?
A watchtower.
Nope, it's not a watchtower. So we have to go to Emmanuel. Emmanuel, can you steal this for 2,000? Are you out there, Emmanuel? All right, we'll move on. Isaiah, for 2,000. This seaside tower shines a light that for ships to see. A, a skyscraper. B, a lighthouse. Or C, a watchtower.
A lighthouse.
It's B, a lighthouse. So Isaiah has $2,000. You're up to $4,800. All right. Mayanika, are you out there? Okay, guys, one thing that we're going to talk about staying in the camera. I have to tell you, because there's a lot of times where I'm passing your card, your screen over, because you're not participating with us. You're doing something else. If you cannot stay focused, then we cannot allow you to play the game. So I need you to stay in the camera. You understand?
I didn't know about it.
Mayanika, do you understand?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Okay, Mayanika, yes. Pick a category and a value.
Oh, I'm wrong.
Category and a value. There's no more compound words. We're all out of those. They have to have a value in their row in order to call them.
I'm
So what time is it tomorrow? Hi, Nikki, you have 10 seconds to pick something.
When is it? What time? Tomorrow?
Category and a value.
You say you mix.
Okay, we have to move on. Mariana, it's your turn. You got to pick a category and a value. Mindy, could go ahead and mute again.
Definition?
Definition for?
400?
400.
Hey, girl, you still got your furniture? Take off speaker. You still got your furniture? She's okay.
Somebody needs to mute.
How much?
Okay, Mariana, here's your question. What is the correct definition of the word shelter? Shelter. A collector of shells. B, a structure that covers or protects something. Or C, a thick, warm sweater. Which word is the correct, what is the correct definition of the word shelter? A, a collector of shells. B, a structure that covers or protects something. Or C, a thick, warm sweater. Mariana?
B?
It's B, you got it. And that was?
400.
400, Mariana. So you're at 1800. 1,800. Okay, let's try Carson again. Carson, are you still there? Okay, we'll go to, well, we're gonna stop here because we only have so many minutes left. All right, guys, so of this game, we gotta get better at staying focused, number one. But at this game, we had De'Asia. She had 2,200 points. Isaiah had 4,800 points. And Mariana had 1,800 points. You guys did a great job. All right, so let's go back to our brain break.
This activity works best when sitting. Press pause and take a moment to get comfortable in your seat. When you're ready to begin, press play. You probably find it pretty easy to be nice to people that you like very much. But how do you feel about being nice to people that are frustrating or annoying to you? Sit up tall in your chair, put both feet on the ground, and rest your hands in your lap. Close your eyes and imagine that you are sitting all by yourself in this room. Notice what it feels like to sit with yourself. Now imagine someone that you care about very much, someone who's very easy to like. Imagine that person walking into this room and sitting down right in front of you. Let's send them some caring wishes. Say after me. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you be safe. May your life be filled with joy. How did you feel when you gave caring wishes to this person? Happy, proud, sad? Now bring your hands onto the tops of your legs. Inhale and roll your shoulders back, lifting your heart, looking up. Exhale and round your back, looking towards your belly button. Inhale and lift. Exhale and round. Inhale. Exhale. Now sit up and close your eyes again and imagine someone you think is a little annoying or frustrating. Maybe it's your sister or brother that sometimes drives you crazy, or a friend that you often argue with, or it could even be a teacher or a parent that bothers you at times. Imagine that person walking into the room and sitting down in front of you. What does it feel like to sit with this person? Let's send them some caring wishes. Say after me. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you be safe. May your life be filled with joy. Was it harder to send this frustrating person carrying wishes? Take a breath in and lift your arms overhead. As you breathe out, round your back and wrap your arms around you as if you're giving yourself a hug. Breathe in and lift up. And breathe out and lift your opposite arm around you. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and exhale and put the opposite arm around you. Come back to a comfortable position with both feet on the floor and your hands on your lap. Close your eyes and bring that person who's a little bit frustrating or annoying back into the room. Sometimes people annoy and frustrate us because they're having a hard time. Do you think you've ever annoyed someone else when you were having a bad day? As you send this frustrating person some caring feelings again, notice if how you feel about it changes. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you be safe. May your life be filled with joy. Open your eyes. Does sending caring feelings to this person feel any different this time? Close your eyes one last time and imagine the room exactly as it is. Notice what it feels like for you to be in this room at this moment. And then send everyone in this room some caring wishes saying, may we be happy. May we be healthy. May we be safe. May our lives be filled with joy. Notice what it feels like to send caring feelings to everyone around you. Remember that being kind to other people is a choice that you get to make each day. Even when it's hard, you can send people caring wishes, and it just might make you feel better too.
Okay, so now it is our 2 minutes of fame. So today, is De'Asia still here? De'Asia, you're gonna be our person, so you can unmute. Everybody else stays muted. Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right, let me get my clock up for your 2 minutes. And we're going to be your audience. Okay, here you go. First question. What's your full name?
De'Asia Man Duke.
All right. Do you have a nickname?
Beady.
Beady? I love it. What is your favorite color, De'Asia?
Red.
Red. What is your favorite food?
Pizza.
Yum. What is your best memory, De'Asia?
When I went on a roller coaster.
You went on a roller coaster. I like it. What is your favorite sport to play?
Volleyball.
Volleyball? How old are you, De'Asia?
8.
All right. Do you have any brothers or sisters?
Yes.
Who? What's their name and how old are they?
Okay. Mariah, Malia, Darius, Isaac, Craigie and Mari.
Wow.
One's one, another one's six, another one's six. Darius, 11. Craigie, 13. And Isaac, 15.
Wow, I didn't know that you had that many siblings. You learn something new every day. Where's your favorite place to go?
The Tui's.
What's your favorite restaurant?
Pizza King.
Pizza King, yum. That's my favorite too. What's your favorite movie?
Gigi?
Huh?
What's your favorite movie? What's your scary. Favorite movie? Scary movie? Everybody likes scary movies. I don't like those. All right, Deja, that was your 2 minutes. I'm new to give Deja a hand clap.
Okay.
For today. Good job. All right, I got one more person. Is Emmanuel still with us? Emmanuel, turn your camera on and your mic. And then Emmanuel, you're our 2 minutes of you're gonna be famous for 2 minutes. Are you ready?
Yeah.
First question, what's your full name?
Emmanuel Irby.
Do you have a nickname?
And Desiah Irby.
Okay. Do you have a nickname?
No.
What's your favorite color?
Blue.
Can you slide into your camera so we can, because you're on camera right now and you're our famous person. Okay, what's your favorite food?
Pizza.
Yum, I like that too. What's your best memory, our favorite memory?
That must be simple. I hate playing poker with only four.
I don't know.
You don't know? What's your favorite sport?
Football.
Football. Where's your favorite place to go?
To.
I'm sorry, sweetheart. It's just that we're playing real poker, you know.
Disney World.
Okay. What's your favorite movie? I can give you a new question. What's your favorite cartoon? I have to turn your camera on a minute. What's your favorite cartoon?
Oh, scary movies.
Scary movies. Who's your best friend?
Isaiah.
What is your favorite school subject?
Math.
Well, that was your 2 minutes of fame. Everybody turn on your mics and give him a hand clap for being famous for 2 minutes. I love it. All right, so tomorrow.
Good job. Hold on.
Tomorrow we'll have a couple more people to share out. All right, so it is time for our Lexia learning. I love it. Well, wait a minute. You gotta love it when the stuff doesn't show up the way it's supposed to. There it is. Okay, so for today, our Lexia highlights for third grade super independent workers that got on Lexia Learning and was working. We have Isaiah Foster. He worked last night and he actually did 25 minutes. Good job, Isaiah. We had also some more people got in there yesterday.
Okay.
We had Erice Robertson, and she did 31 minutes yesterday. Yeah. Good deal, Erice. I'm going to give you a hand clap. And we also had Carson Olam. He got in there and he did 33 minutes. Give him a hand. Good job. And we also, did we have anybody else? Let me see. We have to remember, this is something I want you guys to remember to do tonight. Do 15 to 20 minutes of Lexi learning on for tomorrow's highlights board. Don't forget it. It's super important so that we can get your name up there and highlight it right along with everyone else. All right. Well, guys, our time is about up. So let's just cheer ourselves out for a job well done. You guys did a fabulous job. Wants you to keep on flying, keep on soaring out there, because it takes all of us to get the job done. 1 second. So, as we leave today, I want you guys to remember tonight when you get home, or if you have time later today, to get out there and do 15 to 20 minutes of your Lexia learning. That's your independent reading program. It helps you to build your independent reading skills. It's really important that you take your time to do that, because just logging in doesn't count. You have to log in and actually work. Lexia learning calculates your actual work time. So don't forget to do it tonight so we can get your name highlighted on tomorrow's board. Everybody get your hand up and wave at everybody. Get your hand up and wave.
Nice.
We'll see you tomorrow. Have a great night.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.